You want a battle goat? You now understand my love for Solus? Why? Because he's a spirit made manifest. Hey. Okay, yeah, we already did. We did. Okay, good, good.
I'll let you rest.
Ah, because you feel like the with the whole, like, you can't have her, like, no. Where is the dang name auger? He's up one of these hills, probably this one.
New faction is good. Fine work.
Oh, the pretty leaves on the houses. Jeez. I love how freaking colorful the basin is. The Storebacker thing really didn't give me any points. Really? Do I have to judge her first? If I have to judge Storebacker and then it'll give me a point, that would be nice.
Be welcome.
I found skulls with spells on them left out by the Hackanites. What are they trying to do?
Skulls. So, bones. Magic cloaked in blood. Stone hidden lie the tales of this hold. Here's the means to find them. Return when you've seen all the god runes, and I'll tell you why the Jaws of Hackle did this.
Why not just say what's going on?
Because you hail from the lowlands. If you'd know more about the Avar, put some effort in the knowing. Besides, those
I love this guy, he's great.
I should be off.
I'm so sorry, some man flesh. I'm sorry that I brought you into the pain and suffering that is a soulless romance. I'm gonna fall right off. Really, Caillouk, I helped you like him too? Well, there you go. I'm just spreading the soulless love everywhere. It's my duty. It's my duty. I definitely see his flaws. There's a couple people that I read about and that I, you know, talk to and stuff that definitely helped me point out his flaws, but I think overall I really like him. I think there was a rune actually up in his house and I missed it. He's definitely a complicated character and I like him. Don't mind me, lady. I love these ones. I remember last time I was like waxing eloquent about how I love how the Avar's gods are. Like, some people are like, oh, Bioware's just being like, oh, look how stupid the Avar are. I'm like, are you joking me? This is like the most legitimate system of worship in the entire game. Like, I love it. It's like, it's the most realistic. I don't know, not realistic, I don't know, it's just the one that makes the most sense to me. It's like, anthropologically, like, people make their own gods, you know? And, like, these guys are totally chill with it, it's not a big deal. Like, their gods have power, and it's great, and it's fine, but they also create them, and they're, like, that's, like, part of their culture, and I love it. Oh, did I miss one? I missed one. No, let me down. I think I missed one. Did I? Or was it? Okay, whatever. Now you think he's freaking a trash? Yay! Dory for life, cheesy beer! No, no! Solus forever! Oh, another one. Perfect. The return. Okay. How's it going? No.
May I help you?
I should be off.
He's a... You know what the thing is, though? Is once you start listening to Solus, and especially in the romance options, it's his voice. It's legitimately his voice that does me in. Like, whichever Andromeda character has the best voice, that's who I'll be romancing. Ah, sorry, guy. Whoa. Dorian is friend-zoned for life. You're gonna punch everyone at one point. Just replay it. Punch him. Not romance solos, just good friends. Yeah, I know. That's good. I know, Talon and Solas kind of had an interesting, at least in my head, they had an interesting relationship where Talon trusted and respected Solas, but he also always felt like Solas was holding something back, and, but everybody has their secrets, right, so it didn't really bother him. But I know, and I know people could say, you're like, oh, it's already because you played the game, and you know what's up with Solas, and I'm like, yeah, so I do. I do know what's up with Solas. So I can make a character that kind of knows what's going on. Well, not, doesn't know what's going on, but... And he asks a couple questions of Solas that I thought were really interesting in the end game. So long as don't mind me just running around with magic fire. I'm just not gonna light all your plants on fire. It's his elfin voice. It really is. You love Dorian's romance, but you're just too uncomfortable. Hey, you know, it's not for everybody.
Our guests are welcome. So long as
think? What? I could probably climb up there and get something. Are we good? I read them all. You are not allowed to go with my first choice for Andromeda. Mass Effect 2 Thane says hello! You don't understand, I just played Mass Effect 3 where, I just played the part where what happens to Thane happens, and I just cried so much. I cry every time.
Was about your gods returning, but in different forms.
One of our oldest stories, taught to us as children by the Skalds.
The dwarf, yeah, those stories when you ask him about ruins, the dwarf with the stone, it's really cute. Like, it's very interesting and poignant, his stories.
They will not let him die and return as he should. The blood magic was to hide the jaws of Hakon's deed from other gods.
They have powerful magic. Why the jaws of
and it aggravates me that the Inquisitor keeps calling them spirits when they call when the Avar call them gods. Like, can't we just respect their culture a little bit?
Hide their deeds from shame.
Like, at least we can say your gods. We don't have to say god, like the gods. You know, we could say your gods.
I'd like to ask something.
All right.
Then ask.
Whoever this guy is, whoever this voice actor is, I love him. Oh, wait. Boop, 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 boop. Level up, Dorian. Shoot, Dorian, what do you want? I guess we could bump up, we could also get his barrier better. Ooh, Spirit Knight protects your allies for a short time, reducing incoming damage and reviving them if they fall unconscious. Whoa! Allies who are already unconscious fight with great power for a few seconds before falling. No! Yeah, let's do that one. Greetings! Did I get points yet? 3! Oh, cool. Did I get 2 from helping out the auger? Do I have to go talk to the Thane again to judge Storvacher?
Our guests are welcome, so long as their weapons stay sharp.
He's such a good little Tivinter mage. How do I judge Storvacher? Or is it something, do I have to go to the war table? I might have to go to the war table.
Have you found a way through that wall of ice around the Hakonite fortress?
Oh, I have to finish the DLC? Farewell. Oh, okay, so it's not. So I didn't get a point for helping find Storvacher. That's stupid. Stupid. And we already did the one where we can this one will help us finding Runa. And then there's also another one with the Augur's assist, the Augur's apprentice. How do we get the Augur's apprentice one?
So long as their
weapons station. New section is good. Fine work.
He sounds like Sean Bean. Yes. Yes. Oh, nice. Yeah, Thane's mission and Samara's mission are the only ones where you don't have to fight anything in Mass Effect 2. Phew. Put away. Oh, good. We're right close. Right close. Did I recruit the guy in the Fallow Mar- the Avar dude? Yeah. I think I did. I did send him to the hold, the reward table mission, and he's. I think I sent him on a. I think. Oh, I can't remember. I don't know if I sent him with Cullen or with Josephine, but I think in the way I sent him, he actually slept with Svara's sun hair, and she was like, he was as good in a fight as he was in bed, and I was like, oh my gosh! I was like, good for you! Diplomacy in every way! Oh my gosh! It was funny. Stormbacker is a very funny. What is it? What is it? What does it mean?
Let's look around.
Look around for hints as to what. But. But yeah. Oh, the axe! There it is.
A lot of loose stone here, and an Avar axe.
Someone left it on purpose. A trail marker.
The woman at the beach said her cousin Runa went climbing. Maybe this is where she began.
White hat. We'll just, since we're here. Not that I plan on opening this, but I hate to just pass it. Zero shards found. Big and beautiful. She's big and beautiful. Stormbacker. Ah. Avar. Or Jaws of Hagon. What's the point in playing if not to fight? Well, sometimes it's nice to not do fighting ones. Just kind of talk your way out of a situation. They better give you more than two voices in Dragon Age 4. Well, they gave us four in Inquisition. Whee! I don't know, I didn't, the options that you get, what I really kind of hope for is a body mesh. Like, something you can mess with body meshes. I'd like to be able to do that. Because, I don't know. It'd be nice, not even like a big difference, but it'd be nice to make a little difference, maybe. Especially because the male elf body mesh just did something, they did something stupid with it, and it looks ridiculous. They gave us two for each gender? 4, 5, or 10! Yeah, good luck with that. That would be so much money. So much money. Especially with the amount of dialogue that they have in these games.
I think our mountain climber
was here. What is this? Come on. Yes. Oh, thought, isn't it bought Freddie Prinze Jr. cookbook? What? No, I haven't. This way. Oh, yeah. That's true. That's right. Freddie Prinze Jr. His book. His book. I think I've seen a picture of it. Freddie Prinze Jr. is awesome. He freaking loves. He loves the work he does. Oh my gosh! Don't no! Don't be attacking these guys. We have. There's literally no reason. Everybody, just chill out. You can have a voice actor that's good at multiple voices. It would still take a long time, and you still have to pay him a bunch of money. Jeez. Where am I going? This is the backside. Oh, yeah. Well, no, that's not where I want to go. It would not surprise me that Iron Bull could just, like, whip up an apron and, like, make something fantastic. Would not surprise me in the least. Alright, Runa, where you at? I went that way, but... Kind of seems like it was getting off track, but maybe not. What? Ah!
Another marker here.
Okay. Where am I going? Yeah, shush, 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 shush. I don't know where I'm going. Up here? There's some Everite. Oh, there's bad guys. Also bad guys. Look at this place. Look at this place. Oh, that's the Jaws of Hakon stronghold right there. Don't mind us. Don't mind us. That's true. James Vegas seemed like seemed like the type who was really proud of his eggs. That was funny. That was a very funny scene. I liked it. Yeah, killed it. The death blow upgrade's been nice. Hey girl, you all good?
Well fought. I'd heard lowlanders were about. You'd be the Inquisitor.
Yeah, my hand.
From the hand.
Your cousin was looking for you.
Oh, the fishing. I was to help.
Cool bow. Can I get your bow?
I must make an offering to the gods first. Shall I give your names in the prayer?
What's an offering prayer?
I've climbed this hill 1,000 times. Today,
like a Dalish elf wouldn't know what an offering prayer type thing was.
I was going to thank the gods with a brace of nugs. That beast must have scented the meat.
What?
You offer meat to spirits.
The Lady of the Sky sends her birds, and Korth Mountain Father sends his wolves and bears. They wouldn't normally hear the prayer of a lowlander.
You always get chills when they mumble stuff like that? Yeah, I know, it's kind of creepy.
I'd be honored to be mentioned in your offering.
The spirits
Thank you.
Will remember.
Right.
Ha ha! Bull, shut up! Oh my gosh, Cassandra!
Wise. Sometimes the spirits
but Dorian slightly approved. I didn't realize you guys were gonna have opinions. Jeez. Optional. Observe the prayer.
The lady keeps the skies where blows the morning wind. Korth grants mountain shelter.
but lazy.
Hide and bone. Take this gift from Runa Lears Dotton and the Inquisitor from the lands below.
Wah!
I just felt something.
A blessing? That's a good sign.
Woo!
Fine luck, Herald.
Well, I didn't expect it to just pop up.
All right, then.
Moving on.
Moving on.
We've been favored.
Oh, plus one dexterity.
Always appear. I'll tell Lena this tale. Perhaps a good story will put a smile on her face.
Yay! I did a good job. I would love to be friends with your gods. I'm sure it could only be a good thing to be friends with your gods while I'm in your area. Arble. Oh yeah, you're gonna give him some more constitution. Have some more constitution, Iron Bull. Cassandra. Would love to give you Blessed Blade. Boop, boop. Instead of, which one though? Which one? Dorian Fly! You didn't realize I gave a crap about food? Oh, make Bull some armor that ups his health? Well, I already made him this set of armor. Yeah, I just made it for him. I probably should, though. I think I would have if I'd have seen it in the options, but maybe I just missed it. We'll give her that one instead of that one for now. Yay. So now I have 4 out of 5. Well, how do I find the... Oh, she's up... Well, I can't... Talking to her doesn't really do anything, does it? Unless I go talk to her and then... And then the quest pops up where the, like I mention it to the auger. I'm like, oh, hey, by the way. Just accept that Bull is not a tank. No! No! Oh, the Avar ladies do have great voices. They're very good. I don't know why I didn't give him health when I made his armor. Let's see. I did. Looks like I did. I gave him plus 25 constitution. So there. It's just not doing a whole heck of a lot. Woo. I do need to talk to her to start the quest. Okay, where is her hut? I swear I passed it, but maybe not. Who date? I don't want to go to the arena. Blah. Who date? Oh, that's a shard. I don't care about the shards. Vanagil. And it was more a quote than me saying things. There's a medal that gives 250 max health. Holy crap. Well, I obviously do not have that medal. Jeez. Well, that's awesome. Augur's Apprentice. I'm looking it up. Apprentice. Inquisition. Over to the far left. She's way over here. Really? She's that far away. Jeez. Who are you? Oh, that's the river one. Speak to her south of the Ridgeline Camp. Ridgeline Camp. She's south of it somewhere. So, we'll just move south. South. No, I do not have the shards on my face. Those are too distracting. What? Move south immediately and jump down. If you do the main... Oh, is that because, like, you'd be... Oh, yeah, because you'd be following a Meriden's trail. That's a shard. Okay. Okay, let's just use the lift. Go down. South. Wait, she's up there, though. She is up on the ridge. I know that. in a nice little house, just chilling. What? Oh, I think, oh yeah, this is the trail of that guy. Nobody gonna say anything. I think I found the trail too soon. Because last time I was really confused because I kept finding stuff like that and nobody was saying anything. Like my Inquisitor wasn't saying anything and I was like, what the even is going on here, you know? Because it looked like the stuff that you get from, or like that happened back when the, you know, the temple exploded. So I was like, what the crap is going on? And I, even when I found the end result, I was like, I still have no idea what's going on. Like, I had to, like, read up about it because it was very confusing. Yo!
No,
hello to you
no,
too.
No, I cannot have guests, lowlanders, even those who don't hail from the home.
Hey, how's it going?
Who are you? And why are you out here?
If I tell you, will you
of
leave
course.
Me be? I am Sigrid Goldsdottir, Augur's apprentice. I exiled myself from Stonebear Hold.
You exiled yourself?
Aye, I did. And my tongue will say no more on that.
Yay, time to go talk to the Augur now. You still can't see those tree bases without your brain screaming Ewoks? I don't blame you. Alright, now that we found her... Oh, today back there. I think that's a... Actually, I don't know what that is. Boop. Boop. Just traveling back and forth across the map. I'm just trying to make friends, okay? I'm just trying to make friends with everybody. I ran out of vanilla Coke soda, like cans, and so I've gone to the gas station every so often to get bottles, but I prefer to drink cans because they're smaller. It's not as much soda. Doesn't go warm as fast. Freaking love the Augur. He has the best voice. The best voice.
Be welcome.
I met an exile.
I met a mage in the woods who said she used to be an Augur's apprentice.
Sigrid Goldsdottir. She left the hold when I told her she must release her teacher.
Aren't you her teacher?
She might have heeded me if I were. Oh, perhaps not. It's time the spirit in her was free.
Oh my gosh!
Every mage in the hold is made one with the gods.
I love the Avar!
I thought Sigrid strong enough. Exile.
I love it. Such an interesting notion. Like, such an interesting way to go about doing things.
By the shore for her rite of thanksgiving. A ritual to part her from her teacher. Sigrid claims her offering was spurned by the gods. The spirit remains with her, which is taken.
I have questions.
I'd like to ask something.
Then ask.
You let spirits possess your mages on purpose.
What better teacher?
I love it!
The spirits in the hold have
I love it.
Hundreds of years. Once a mage masters their powers, their teacher departs. Duty ended.
So wait. So this actually, I just realized, like, this is really important for, like, Anders' situation. Like, apparently, the spirit can leave if it wants to. Like, it can if it's like a benign possession, it seems like. So maybe this is actually a big hint for something that happens in the next game, that, like, we start figuring out more things about benign possession. Because when a spirit not benignly possesses you, like, takes over, like, obviously, at least as far as we know, we can't kick it out without killing the host, you know. And the person's will has been completely taken over. But if the person is still conscious and the spirit is, like, conscious and they're working together, apparently it can leave. It can go bye-bye. It's, like, all good and fine, and then the person is no longer possessed. So I wonder if this is some sort of retcon thing, because Anders said that they could not be separated anymore. Flemeth says that she can't be separated from Mythal anymore. That they're one and the same, you know. But apparently the Avar have been being possessed and unpossessed by spirits for centuries. Who is Anders? Anders is somebody very important in Dragon Age 2, Kayuk.
What happens to these weak mages?
Their teachers stay with them, and the other gods watch them both, so neither soul turns sick. If one does sicken, other mage stands in risk of harming the hold. One day, they do not wake in their bed. It is very sad. It is what must be done.
Do you mean you let a spirit?
It's more benign than shoving them in a friggin' tower and letting them, like, go through a harrowing, I think. Exactly, same thing with Wynn, Kayuk. Although her spirit didn't want to leave, I think when the spirit left is when Wynn would die. Or when the spirit ran out of energy. And Mythos, not just any old spirit. That does make sense. Anders was taught his whole life that's how possession works. I wonder if Justice knew any different, though, or if Justice actually didn't care, you know, in the end. He was like, the Justice in him was like, this is how it has to be, you know, like it couldn't be any other way. This is the way it has to be. But that's really interesting that apparently benign possession, you can actually go in and out of a benign possession. I realized that when I played this last, but putting it all together, especially because the last time I played this, I hadn't played Origins or 2. So that's really cool. The spirit was keeping Wynn alive, yep, yep. Anders deserves better than that, than to be possessed, like how he was, or for Justice to kind of take advantage of him. Gotta go down the other way, jeez. Justice didn't really know anything about mortals or the physical war, but he knew he was a fade spirit. So, I mean, unless this is all stuff that's like being sort of retconned, you know, and so we have to justify it in some other way, where it's like, oh, Justice didn't know or something, you know, but he was a fade spirit. He knew about the stuff that goes on in the fade, like, I mean, I guess you can't say, you probably could say that Justice doesn't know everything, but still, it's curious. I mean, if he didn't know, not really his fault.
This is the place the Augur said that mage, Sigrid.
But apparently the Avar spirits are used to this.
Looks like the tools for her ritual are still here.
The Avar know... Maybe it's sort of an Avar secret, you know? Oh, wait, what? Oh, I see what you're saying. Anders deserves better than that. Justice didn't know about physical. He could have been corrupted by what Anders... Oh, Justice was totally corrupted by Anders. He became a vengeance spirit, but... Justice makes it pretty clear in Awakening that spirits don't... And that's the thing, is he does say that in Awakening, that spirits don't know a whole lot about...
Scorch marks.
I mean, I guess...
Magic. I think it's excess energy from stopping a spell mid-cast. Maybe Sigrid never...
I wonder if, I mean, it would have to be a certain type of spirit that would know that. So maybe the Avar spirit gods are the only ones who really know about this. About the benign possession and unpossession thing. Oops. So that would make sense.
The grass is trampled down here. Fight?
No. See the hoof prints?
Oh. Interesting, because I think last time we were like, oh, possibly a fight, you know? And I don't think anybody said anything to contradict it. But Bull does contradict it, so... And it's interesting that he's... I like that a lot! It's like archaeology, sort of, where you have to read what's important and what's not. It's like a crime scene analysis, where, like, something came through and contaminated the site later. And you have to separate what was from the thing and what was not from the thing.
You backhanded that guy with your shield and then damn near chopped him in half. Hey, are you as turned on as I am right now?
Am I what?
That's probably impossible anyway.
Oh my gosh. Oh, Bull's being chatty. Oh, Dorian. Dorian, you're so beautiful in that royal sea silk. But did Anders die if Hawk romanced Anders and was left in the fade, or was that not a thing? This is a whole different system. The spirits join. The spirits join, expecting to leave. Ooh, good point. You could say you agree. You think they are shaped by expectation. Exactly. And Kayik's basically saying the same thing because it's the way the Avar sees. That's true. You cannot underestimate. That's a very good point. You cannot underestimate the perception of the people interacting with the spirits because they change based on perception. So that's a good point. That's a very interesting point.
If this mage did the ritual, why are the offerings still here?
Good question.
I like that, actually. A lot.
Vial of Lyrium. If you don't know what you're doing, it takes a lot of energy to banish a spirit. Then why is the vial still full?
She tossed it. She said, no! I don't want my spirit friend to leave. Whoop. Looks like we might. Hey, Seshu, I hope you can hear me. There's an advertisement going on right now, so I can't see anything. Also, it's the stupid Matt Damon one that doesn't go away. Oh, crap. This is lame. Man, now I'm gonna have to reload and miss what you guys said. Don't say anything else about the situation we were talking about, because now I have to reload. I'm so mad. Dang it. The beauty of streaming. Did it go away? Am I cheating on you with Matt Damon? Yeah. If I had that option, I would do it. Yeah, in a heartbeat. Dang it! And you guys were saying stuff about the Anders Justice thing and the freaking spirits thing. Oh, that's so frustrating. We had a cool conversation going. Ah, stupid! Damn you, Matt Damon! Matt Damon! Think of how many times Solas talks about how spirits change. Yeah, exactly. Well, like, if you encounter them in the Fade, like, a spirit of wisdom can become a spirit of pride, depending on how you encounter it, you know? So, and the Avar, they talk intensively about all of it. Anyway, we see, you know, that they talk about. What? You guys are so cute! I love you! But, no, I don't know. We were saying cool things. Or... picture! No! What? Are you guys still talking? Of course you would only say nice things about me. Seshu, hi! Did I say hi? I hope you heard me say hi, Seshu. Because I saw you just as I had to reload the stream, and I was like, no! Let's just go. Let's just fast travel back to her. Because she's all the freaking way across. Asan is cheating on you with Harding. Sorry! Poor some man flesh. Oh. I like that, though. I mean, perception is such a big deal with spirits in this game. Well, at least it's talked about being a big deal, you know? Whether or not it actually becomes a big deal is something that might be limited by game processing and all that, but I like the idea. I like that maybe they're planting that idea for the game, for the future games. Sorry, I'm coughing. But you could have both. Boy, howdy. Sign me up. I'll leave Matt Damon for your elves. In a heartbeat. What? away. I don't want to fight you. He lost his chance. I really hope that they do something with that, with the whole perception of spirits, and hope they bring back a little bit of what the Avar were telling us in this DLC. I mean, I know some people like don't like that, like the DLCs and the books are pretty important to like understand what's going on in the games, but I like it. Disengage. I did.
The Augur told me why you're here.
That to Jay. What business is it of his to tell that to a lowland?
You mean like they are planting an idea that souls can control you because he's absorbed mythos? Shut up, Kaiyuk! Oh man, he's not gonna do it. He's not. I wonder if he is though. It's gonna be like a battle of wills between the Inquisitor and Solas, like as like an enemy, like as like an antagonized Solas. He's gonna be like fighting you like legitimately, but like as a, and that'd be really cool if it played into that. If it was actually more difficult to like defeat Solas if you antagonized him, and like if it came down to a battle of wills, that it was an actual battle, but that if you were like if you had romanced him or if you'd be good friends with him, it was like different. And, like, you... Oh, no. Dang it, stupid ad again! Oh, stupid Matt Damon ad. I don't know why I'm having troubles like this. Cause my Elgato says it's fine. But it'd be cool if the game was more difficult with Solas if you antagonized him rather than if you romanced him or made friends with him. And then, like, the Battle of Wills was, like, Solas slowly eroding cause he didn't want to do what he's about to do or whatever, you know? Quick anarchy!
You were performing, Sigrid.
I'm not watching.
To burn a proper offering, then let my guiding spirit free. I made the offering.
Lies!
The gods did not accept.
I found a bird and incense by the altar. They weren't burnt at all.
I brought more than I needed. When I fled, I left everything.
You would have needed to take the at the
start. Rito, I think you're right. Matt Damon is stalking me.
The file I found was full.
Do you accuse me, stranger?
What I saw doesn't make sense. Like you never did the ritual at all.
So even a stranger senses my shame. I made no offering. I prepared. I began the spell to release the spirit.
Rito.
And?
I could not do it.
So the cool kids say.
I have no close companions in the hold, no kin. I cannot lose my only friend.
You're friends with this.
We are friends with Cole. Like, how can we say something like that when we're friends with Cole's?
Since I was a child, frightened of the fire I could suddenly call down. The gods change, the gods can die, and yet I do not want to lose the one who loves me.
So how does your teacher feel about this? Does it...
Oh, that's the only kind thing we've said about spirits this whole time.
If I asked, the gods that teach the spirit touched a kind. I think the Augur knew. All this time, he knew I never cast the ritual. It is not right to stay in pity. I will confess to him.
Good idea.
It's for the best. Maybe the Augur will help you release your spirit friend.
I do not need his help.
I like this girl. She's proud, but you know.
Farewell,
she's smart too. I like her. Cool kids. Cool kids. Avar girl has a butt. Is that it? It's like asterisked out. It's just her costume. It's just her armor. Did I get a point? I don't know if I did. press the hold. Ah, no, wrong way, wrong way. I'm panicking. Impress the hold with my, my feet of awesome. How do I impress the hold? How do I impress you people? I gotta go talk to Thane Sunhair, I think. Sorry, you're a but elves! Yeah, elves don't have much of a butt, usually.
Have you found
no, but I did, what, I impressed people.
I'll speak with you later.
Maybe I should go talk to the Augur about his apprentice. Yeah, elves don't have butts. Unless you're a Lord of the Rings elf, then you're this tall, willowy, beautiful thing. But in Inquisition, or in Dragon Age, the elves are short. Frail.
Greetings, stranger.
Talk to your girl.
I had a visit from Sigrid Gulsdottir. She had much to tell me.
I love you!
From her spirit.
Only she may fulfill that oath. But together, we will seek guidance.
I love you!
I'd like to ask something.
Dang it.
Then ask.
How do you impress the hold?
Farewell.
Is that still... I think I remember this being confused by this last time. How do I impress the hold? Do I gotta do the fight thing? Because I don't want to do the fight thing. Have you seen the female elves? The male elves are worse in Inquisition. They're just like the tiny, skinny, scrawny things. The girls at least look willowy in some sort of way. I'm gonna go to the bathroom again. Tell me what you got. How do I trigger impressing the hole? My poor doggy. I don't think he's eaten today. Saturdays are always rough because all the adults wake up late. I do have to do the fight thing. Aww. I don't want to do the fight thing. Oh well. Yeah, you gotta do the hack-ons trial. Dang it. I was kind of hoping to avoid that. My squeaky chair. All right. We're almost done making friends. Whoop. Hang on. Where am I? Okay, good. I'm all filled up, at least health potion wise. But punching people with my bow and arrow. With my arrows. I punch people with my arrows. With my cool new bow that I got.
What did I tell you?
Lowlanders. Lowlanders. Sashu. We are all terrible. We're all terrible people. I think he's saying we are all terrible people. Terrible people.
Our guests are welcome. So long as they're
yay,
welcome.
Thanks. Boop. I'm gonna claim your house. Oh, here it is. One of the tales of the ice troll.
Every time I think I've seen the ugliest possible of our statue. A new one turns up that surpasses my expectations.
Good freaking point.
So?
Sure.
Come to test yourself.
How so?
Our warriors want your measure, Inquisitor. Bring us an offering.
Oh my gosh, I got
Bear Hold would know if the spirits favor you. So would I.
Okay, bye.
Farewell.
We run back to Skyhold, I guess.